Hello and welcome to your third favorite podcast. Today we are celebrating National Dog Day.
Bow wow, woof woof. Josh, I think that Benny doesn't really like Kevin because I keep on hearing some tiny little growls.
Benny doesn't like many other dogs, but we should probably give an intro to all these dogs. So
yes,
JJ's holding my in-law's dog, Benny, who was rescued from the streets of Yucaipa when he was 3 months old.
Wow. And he's also hypoallergenic, which is great for me.
Yeah, so that's why JJ is holding that dog. This is me and my wife's newest dog, Ghost. She doesn't understand plastic tables, obviously.
Or how to be on camera, clearly.
She has horrible camera presence. However, that leads us into my other dog, Kevin, who has been wonderful on camera so far. But I don't think we can do this whole podcast with three dogs.
Yeah,
so
let's
get rid of the mean one, the young one, and let's keep the fat one. Okay. Matt, can I hand this dog to you?
All right, Benny, I'm going to let you down.
There you go. Yep, just toss her in the back.
Hi, Kevin.
Hey, Kev.
How are you? So some of you are probably like, wait a minute, National Dog Day, that happened on August 26th.
Yeah, you all know exactly when National Dog
Day
is.
Obviously, we know that, but yes. We didn't have a podcast then.
But we do now, so.
So here we are, exactly 10 weeks later, mm-hmm. celebrating the 10-week anniversary from National Dog Day 2020.
And we have a guest. Our very first guest on your third favorite podcast is my dog, Kevin. He is a purebred Corgi. When we bought him, they gave us like his papers to show that he was official and like full blood Corgi or whatever. And so had all the names of the Corgis ever in his bloodline. So it was like Elizabeth and Reginald. And then he gets to me and Brent and we name him Kevin.
Kevin. Hi, Kevin.
He's doing so good.
He looks really, I think I love about Corgis, they always look really smiley.
Looks smiley. He looks very happy. Fun. Kevin, do you like games? You want to play a game? You have a game for us, JJ?
I do have a game. So, as you all know, we're celebrating National Dog Day. And so we're bringing back one of our games that we played before. It's called Caged, but with a twist. We are playing Caged Air Bud Edition. Now, as many of you probably know, there have been lots of Air Bud movies in the Air Bud cinematic universe, mm-hmm. if you will.
Yep.
And it's hard to keep track of all the ones that they have to offer.
Yeah.
So we're playing Caged Air Bud Edition. Our director, friend, producer, Matt Torrey is going to be giving us a title of a possible Air Bud film. And Josh, we have to decide if that is what?
If we think the movie is a real Air Bud movie, we will hold up the sign that says Air Bud. But if we think it's one that Matt has made up, we'll hold up the sign that says Air Dud.
But there's one more twist.
We have some shot callers here on set with us that we promise you, Kevin is not wearing.
Kevin is looking at me very seductively right now, and I'm uncomfortable.
I would never put a shot collar on my dog. However, I would put one on my friend and myself. So
whenever we get one wrong, Matt will press the shock button, and we'll
don't do it. I'm trying to get all these right. I'm so nervous.
We will get an electric shock. Okay.
All right. Are you guys ready?
Wait.
No.
Wait. Let's ask Kevin if he has anything to say. Kevin, you got any thoughts? None at all.
Okay. I am extremely nervous about this.
I am too. Okay, how quick is it going to happen?
I will tell you the title of a movie in the Air Bud franchise, and you have, let's say, a few seconds to decide before you must put up the sign at the same time, Air Bud or Air Dud.
How many are there?
6 movies.
Oh, my gosh. And The shock increases with each wrong answer.
The shock will increase every time you get one wrong.
All right, let's try not to scare Kevin, but I don't know if he can.
Oh, gosh.
All right, the first movie that we will be talking about is Air Bud Spikes Back.
Air Bud Spikes Back. So that sounds like it would be volleyball.
I think I know the answer.
Oh, are you holding it up?
Are you ready?
Yeah. Count us down, Matt.
3, 2, 1.
I'm saying Air Dud.
Right, I'm saying Air Bud.
Someone's getting shocked here.
Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. Oh.
That was an actual Air Bud film.
Oh, no.
My throat. I thought it was like too much of a Star Wars reference to be real.
Oh, I'm going to choke.
All right, let's move on.
I don't know if I'm going to be swallowed after this.
Our next film is Air Buddies Off the Leash.
Air Buddies Off the Leash.
Air Buddies Off the Leash.
Okay, you ready?
No, I'm not ready. I think so.
You know what's interesting is are you looking at my
car? No, I'm not looking at your car.
You better the frick not be.
Why?
I like now that it's hurt really freaking bad, but now that the anticipation's over, it's like, okay, I'll just have to take it again. But for you, you're
the
like
anticipation is killing me.
Okay.
Three, right. Two, one.
Good.
I'm saying Air Bud, that's a real one.
Oh, I said yeah.
Did it actually?
You both should have been shocked.
Ow. Oh, it didn't work for me.
I just got shocked.
Oh, okay, stop. Okay, it's okay, buddy. It's okay.
That is not an actual Air Bud movie.
Oh, it worked. It worked after a second.
Okay. Oh, my heart's being so
fast. I'm sorry, buddy. I'm sorry. Okay, so it's okay. It's okay. I'm like, now I'm having to console myself and my dog.
So what we didn't say is the winner of this game gets 100 points in our season-long competition, and also the loser will have to keep the shock collar on, and Matt gets two times in the episode where he gets to shock at random.
Two?
Two.
All right, our next film is Air Bud, Putting from the Rough.
What?
Putting from...
Oh my gosh, I hate this so much.
I don't. Yeah. Honestly, I was more scared for this one than the pregnancy simulator, the labor simulator. Hey, buddy.
At least like with that, it's like continued pain. This is like it's the anticipation that's the worst. Okay, I think I know what I'm
Three,
going for.
Three, two, one.
I say Air Bud.
I said Air Bud.
Not real.
You are both correct. Not a real Air Bud movie.
Oh, praise God! All
right, it's 2-1. Okay, I need to catch up though. Ooh. We have three more.
Our next film is Treasure Buddies.
Treasure Buddies? What?
It's the Pirates of the Caribbean spinoff.
Yeah, that's great. Okay.
Okay. Count us down, Matt.
Three, two, one.
I'm saying Air Bud. That's real.
That's real.
No!
That is a correct answer.
I'm looking at Matt off screen, and I thought he was going
to
press it.
Every time his thumb goes towards that freaking button... okay.
All right. Our next film is Santa Paws 2, The Santa Buddies.
Santa Paws 2?
That's a long title. There are so many.
Okay. I think I'm ready. So I'm ready. Many? I'm ready.
God, I don't want to shoot. Okay. Count us down, Matt.
Three, two, one.
I'm saying Air Bud. That's it. Frick.
That is an actual Air Bud film.
Oh, dang it.
I
said frick because I need to say something different than you in order to tie.
Yeah, well,
what happens if we tie? Do we both have to keep it on?
Let's cross that bridge when we get to it. Our last film is Space Buddies.
Space Buddies?
Space Buddies.
Okay. All right.
Wait, I need a second to think.
I think, yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Oh, why'd you just turn it up?
No, just turning it back on.
Okay. Count us down, Matt.
I'm ready.
Three, two, one.
That's a movie.
I said Air Dutch.
Somebody's about to be shocked.
No. Ow! Oh, gosh.
I'm taking my collar off.
Space Buddies is an actual Air Bud movie. JJ wins 4-2.
And I have to keep mine on?
Yes. You got to tighten that.
Is it going to be? I'm pulling it away for a sec. I need
a
break.
So I get 100 points.
Can you just do two right now so I can get it off?
Nope.
I gotta say that was one of the scariest things that I have done in a while. That was the shock didn't hurt too bad. It's just all the anticipation.
It is the anticipation, but also I wouldn't say it hurts really bad. But when it happens, it's like
it
I don't know.
You.
I lose all my senses, but screaming.
Yeah, and also, I mean, your shock was way higher than mine because yours went up.
One.
There's one.
Oh my gosh, dude. What the heck? You know what? I'm sweating so bad. You know what?
Josh just got shocked for those of you just listening and wondering what that was.
You know what happens is when you shock me, I go to grab it and then it shocks my hand too. I'm so sweaty. I feel bad for my buddy here, Kevin.
Oh,
I would never do this to my dog.
You have to have that tighter. That's like very loose around your neck. I feel like that shock shouldn't count.
Could you stop it? I got shocked freaking four times during the game. You got it one time. Now I've had it five total, and mine keeps increasing.
Okay, so now that our heart rates have calmed down just a little bit, we are set up for our second segment, which we like to call Puppy Love.
Now, in this segment, JJ and I are going to serenade my dog, Kevy, here and sing him a love song. Now, how we're going to do this is Matt has come up with some titles of love songs that have never been sung before that JJ and I have never seen, and we are going to read these and make them up on the spot and sing them to Kevy Boy here. All right, I'm going to go ahead and pick the song while Kevin falls asleep.
It's okay, Kevin.
Good boy. This is like, it's a good night.
I'm impressed at how well behaved. For those of you listening, Kevin has literally been sitting in his same spot throughout this whole
recording. The only time he's like barked or growled is when we both got shocked. So, okay, I have the title right here. It's called With Your Paw in Mine.
With Your Paw in Mine, a song to Kevin.
Okay, buddy, you ready?
Oh, you've got talons on your paw, and every time I reach my hand, they tickle them.
The cutest dog I ever did saw. If I'd saw a cucumber, I'd pickle them.
K to the E to the V to the I to the N. I want you till the end.
It's you and me and JJ.
And Brenna.
Hand in paw and paw in hand. With your paw in mine, we will conquer the world.
We will conquer the world.
With your paw in mine, I will.
With your paw in mine,
clean up your hurl.
Clean up your hurl. And your poop and your pee when you pee on the hardwood floor.
With your paw in my hand,
we can conquer the world.
Life's hard, but with you by my side, I can do anything.
Life's hard, but with you by my side, we can do anything.
Life's hard, but with your paw in mine, I can face my fears.
Oh, all the fears of the world.
And with your paw in mine, I will kiss your ears.
Ew. That's a little bit sensual.
And when death comes our way, we'll face it together.
And when death comes our way, you and Josh will bathe together.
And by death, I don't mean you, 'cause you'll live forever.
Well, maybe just 14 years. That's about the average life expectancy for a dog, but we hope it's longer.
I will find an experimental drug that allows you to live just as long as me, so we can die at the same time.
And then we'll be buried in the same casket at the graveyard.
Our friends and family will gather around, and they'll all say, oh, what a good hound.
Ow! They'll howl for you, Kevin.
And as our bodies disintegrate in the ground, it'll be you and me.
At the gates of heaven.
Of heaven.
Because all dogs go to heaven.
With my skeleton hand in your skeleton paw, all will be intertwined. And our skin will fall off. And we've lived a great life
with your paw in my hand.
We love you, Kevin. And they called it puppy love.
Well, I'm hungry, Josh. I don't know about you.
I'm very hungry, and I think that song deserves a treat.
Yes, it does. And so it is time for tryhards. Last time we did tryhards, we tried the labor simulators. Today, we're trying dog treats.
And with our special guest. So we're going to rate these and recommend what we think would be the best dog treat. And Kevin is also going to help us. We're going to rank them together, mm-hmm. give it an overall score. So first, we have classic milk bone.
Mm-hmm.
So I say, JJ, you and I probably eat first. I'm going to give you a red one.
Ooh,
you'll get
you.
One in a second, buddy. Okay. It's very. This is a smaller milk bone.
I feel like this is just going to be like.
Okay, go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's just so dry.
It's so dry. It's like a super old cracker. You're not spinning out, are you?
Mm-mm.
Okay. You ready, buddy?
All right, Kevin, let's see what you got. Uh-huh. Kevin, he seems to be really enjoying this. He's smacking his lips.
Smacking his chops. Okay. He's looking for more.
All right.
Although I have seen him more excited than this, I don't think he was, like, he didn't freak out over it.
Okay.
But I think he still liked it.
Okay. So, I mean, for me, that was a solid 2.
I was also going to say 2.
So, Kevin, what do you think your rating is? mm-hmm. Yeah.
I honestly, he was turned this way, and he kind of did, like, this thing with his upper lip. I don't think it's high on his list. I think he'd say, I could eat it. Mm-hmm. But it's not like his favorite treat.
So I would say, I think that's 2s across the board.
2s across. So
that's a 6 total. So
6 out of 15. So since we don't have anything else, we'll just put that right there in the middle.
All right. And what is next?
Bakery pretzel bits. So these are pretzels with real peanut butter filling.
Yeah.
Which I'm kind of excited
about.
It's like,
about. Yeah, the little like peanut butter pretzels that you get at like Trader Joe's and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
They're unsalted because it's salt. I don't know if salt's good for dogs or not, but... Kevin, you're going
to
get one.
There's
okay?
got to be an easier
Kevin's
way to turn around,
right
buddy.
Now.
Okay.
All right.
Tastes the exact same as the...
The peanut butter?
Pretzel filled peanut butter, I mean.
The peanut butter is a little bland. It's a little bland.
It tastes the exact same to me. For Kevin?
Mm-hmm. All right, Kevin. Give it a taste.
Oh, he spit it out.
Uh-oh.
He didn't eat it right away.
Oh, is it because it's slipping out of his mouth, or is it
no,
because
no, he's not, he's like...
Oh, he's afraid of, oh,
he's
no.
Licking it.
He's licking the pretzel. I mean, well, let's see if we could crack that open so we can get into the peanut butter, because I think that would be...
He just bit a corner of it. Okay, he's like eating it. But it doesn't seem like he's enjoying it.
But I'm curious if this is just, you know, hard for dogs.
I'll tell you, it's not hard for dogs. He's had, like, this guy gnaws on bones, and he just sits there for hours
so
and chews on them.
It looked like he really liked it, but he wanted the peanut butter first.
Okay, but I did not seem like he liked the pretzel, and it is a whole treat. So, mm-hmm. for me, I would say that's a 4 out of 5.
I was going to say a 4 as well, because the peanut butter taste for me is not fully where it needs to be.
But yeah. In Kevin's regard, it seems as though he liked the milk bone better, so the only where to go is to 1. I don't think he liked that.
I feel like he liked that better than the milk bone.
No.
Because he was tonguing the peanut butter.
I still don't think he liked it as much.
Okay, well, I would say maybe a 2. Or do you say a 1? If you say 1.
I say
1.
Okay. He's my dog. I've seen him grow up. I've known him since he was 8
okay,
weeks old.
Okay, fine. All right, so that's a total of 9. It's above the milk bones.
Yeah, it's above the milk bones, but that's only because
and
of us.
And next up, we've got Kong Easy Treat.
Let me explain what this is. So there's this toy called a Kong, and you spray it in the Kong, and then a puppy or a dog like licks inside of it, and it's like keeps them occupied and whatnot. So I think you should just pour it in your mouth. Or should we put it on our fingers?
Maybe on our fingers. Okay. All right, so Josh, I'm going to give you a dollop.
No.
Did it go? Tell me.
Yeah, oh. It's going. It's going. Not yet. Not yet, Kevin. Not yet.
Did you get enough?
Yeah, I got enough.
Okay.
And we'll get you in a second, buddy. Okay, you ready?
Yeah, it's okay. All right, ready?
2, 1.
I feel like that's just cheese whiz.
It tastes just like cheese whiz.
But with
a bad aftertaste.
A bad aftertaste.
That's bad.
Mm-hmm.
Here, put another one on my finger. I'll give it to Kevin.
Oh. Ah, gosh, that aftertaste is...
Kevin,
look at that. Oh, Kevin.
Yeah, he's liking that.
Yeah, he's a fan. He wants more of that.
He's swallowing really hard.
So that's a 5 for Kevin.
That definitely seems like a 5. He loves that.
I'm gonna say for me that's probably a 3 for me.
I don't want to copy you again, but I was also gonna say 3 because I liked it in between those two. Mm-hmm.
So that's an 11, and so that is
that's number one. We got two more. Here is another one from that bakery brand. Got this from Target. These are just treats for dogs. They're just like Oreos, basically. Mm-hmm.
They say lick and crunch.
Do you want the white one or the dark one?
I'll take the dark one.
There's one for you.
Thank you.
One for me.
It smells like a cookie.
Yeah, it smells just like a cookie. Right?
A cookie with like a lamb after.
Okay.
After scent.
I'm going for it.
It tastes like a cookie.
Yeah, I don't know the difference. You know what we need to do? We need to tongue the cream. So, right off the bat, it's not as good as Oreos.
Yeah. But for a dog treat, I'm pretty impressed. Kevin? Oh,
Kevin.
Oh, he got mine.
Here, Kev, have a...
He just...
Oh, he is drooling so hard.
Gosh.
Good gracious.
Yeah, he just snagged that out of my hand. So, I think that's as close to a 5 as I'm going to get with a dog treat.
He's challenged.
I think that's a 5 for Kevin, too.
Uh-huh. That is a 5. I wouldn't say I was in love with it, but I guess, like, going off of dog treats, it was a 5.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a 15. That's a straight
that's a
15
perfect
out of 15.
And last, but most certainly not least,
we have bacon strips. You smell that, buddy? With real bacon. No artificial flavors or FD&C colors. I hate FD&C colors in my dog treats, so they have not changed in smell in like however long.
Oh, that actually looks like a piece of bacon.
Hold on, buddy. Hold on. That's
it. Oh, gosh.
Okay.
It smells like bad beef jerky.
Call that band name. Okay. I'm gonna try this. Oh. Big yikes. That's bad. I'm gonna get down.
I can't do it.
You know what I just remembered? When you get past like the outer layer, there's a specific taste. And I have a vivid memory now of trying these as a kid, thinking like, what is my dog eating?
I always wanted to try one and now I regret it.
I'm gonna get it down. Okay, you try that. Mm-mm. He's okay, first off, this is the one he's the most excited for.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, there you go, buddy.
I see. I think for me, it's part of it is scent. Like it smells like bad beef jerky, and then like once you break it open, you can smell the dog treat. Oh wow, he was a fan.
Yeah, he's slapping those lips. No, I can't do it.
That's So I'm gonna give that one a. I'm gonna put that above the milk bone for me. So I'm gonna give it a 2 as well.
I'm giving it a 1. That was my least favorite by far. So
I mean,
you get 1, 2, and then I feel like Kevin, I think he liked the cookies more. So.
Well, he's trying to go back in. He's giving that a 5 for
okay.
sure. He's trying
You're
to get
right.
back into that.
Yeah, he is. That's a 5. So, but cumulative, that's only an 8.
So our definitive ranking is the Three Dog Bakery baked with pure love.
Uh-huh.
Lick and crunch cookies.
Then we got the dog cheese whiz.
The Kong.
Yeah.
And then the peanut butter pretzels.
Then we have the bacon strips, which are 4th, and then the milk bones came in last.
We hope that this helps you decide which treats to give to your dog and which treats that maybe you want to try out with your dog.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So, you know, on this podcast, we care about history. And if we don't look back at what's happened in the past, it's doomed to repeat itself. So, we're throwing it to our friend Tat Morey out there in the field. Tat?
Hey, guys. I'm out here shooting some hoops with my bros today. That's because 119 years ago, on December 1st, 1891, the game of basketball was invented. A gym teacher named James Naismith invented the game using 2 peach baskets and a soccer ball. And the rest is history. Now, if you excuse me, I'd like to go drop some dimes and make it rain. Back to you both in the studio. From Venice Beach, this is Tat Morey.
Thanks, Tat. Well, we've reached the end of our show, and it is time for Mail Time, where we send one of our friends a gift.
Mm-hmm. And today we sent... Oh, gosh! That was number two. I'm taking it off. For listeners, I just got my second shock. Oh, my gosh. You know what I was doing all episode? I was, like, looking over at Matt, and I was like, okay, he's not holding the remote. He's, yo.
That caught me by surprise.
Oh, my gosh.
So, okay. Anyways, as Josh was trying to say, we sent our friend Dan Martin. He has a dog. He's a dog lover. He has a dog named Daisy. Mm-hmm. Very precious little dog. And so we sent him a dog training VHS.
Yep. And some diapers, not only for his dog, but also for him, so they can match.
So they can match. So let's check it out, and here we go.
What's up? Okay, everybody. I got some packages from my dudes, JJ and Josh. Let's see what this is. It's a VHS tape. Oh my goodness. Training the companion dog, basic training 4.
Yes, number 4. Oh know that there's...
We couldn't get 1 through 3.
But what's this?
1 through 3 were fresh sold out.
What a delightful smile, first of all.
He does have a
delightful
smile.
How many guys
can
rock that sideburns look? But he's got the little salt and pepper.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. I mean,
I like that
angle
he's taking
with this.
This
is amazing. So, I got a puppy. Where's this cute thing? Look at this baby.
Oh,
we're going to see. Oh,
hi, Daisy.
Oh, Daisy.
Daisy.
Okay.
And so that makes sense that I got my own. And I think, okay.
I hope he has a VHS player.
I hope so, too.
Basic training 4. So this must be like part 4 of the series.
Yes.
This one.
I mean, Dan, I don't even think you need part 1 through 3.
No.
Let's be real.
So we heard that dogs imitate their humans. So we got each of you a pack of diapers to help with the potty training. We love you, buddy, from Josh and JJ, your third favorite podcast. Well, that's cute.
That is cute.
Men's protective underwear. Look at this.
Uh-huh. That's
men's
that's
protective
for you.
Underwear with
you got an 18 count.
You know, I'm always telling Josh and JJ, I just got like so much stuff to do. If I could just cut out bathroom time, I think that would just be so my days would be so much more efficient.
Damn. I love you so much.
So this
just poo and pee whenever you want.
This is actually really cute. It's comfort diapers for Daisy.
Yeah.
So I'm a
big believer
out pet care.
Being inclusive, right? So everything I do, my dog does. And I'm just glad we'll be able to share in this experience. Oh, man. Okay, well, that was just super cute.
Dan,
and
an amazing dog owner.
I'm actually like kind
of an amazing human being.
We have a VHS player somewhere.
Yes! Well, that's good.
To see, check this out. This guy just looks so jovial. You guys are just always encouraging me with texts and stuff, but to just get a random cute package was so sweet.
Dan, it's going to make me cry.
All right, dudes. Love you. Bye.
Love you, Dan.
We love you, Dan.
Dan, I think I speak for Josh when I say this. Dan is one of the funniest humans on the planet, and it is like... It can come out just like unexpected. He'll say the craziest thing where it's like, where do you come up with that?
And I do want to plug something of his. He comes out with music, and his
band
is called Yield the Ghost. Y-I-E-L-D. Is that how you spell Yield?
Yes.
Yield the Ghost. It's on Spotify, I'm pretty sure, and maybe SoundCloud. So, Dan, thank you so much for being a part of this.
Dan,
we really do love you.
We love you.
Amazing.
We love you. Well, this has been the National Dog Day celebration
10 weeks late
on your third favorite podcast. We hope you had as much fun as we did, and I wish that Josh could get shocked just one more time.
No, it's okay. And thank you, Kevin, for joining us.
Yes.
We love you, buddy.
Kevin,
now,
what a wonderful guest.
He's gonna go on a walk with us because he's getting super fat from all those treats. Well, he is fat, but he's getting fatter,
and we are going to walk off the treats that we just ate. See you next time.
Bye.
Man, you gotta bring Kevin on the show more often.
He's really what's gonna bring the subscribers.
Yeah, I think.
Oh my gosh.
Come on.
We forgot again.
Jeez, I feel like a big dumb idiot. Here we are, you know, halfway through season 1, and we haven't asked people to like and subscribe. Not once.